Hi y'all, I'm JM of Real Guys Reviews, and I want to visit with you a little bit today about this Charter Arms Pitbull 40 caliber revolver. Get them all emptied out here. As Jeff Quinn says on Gun Blast, this is a dandy little gun. I got this gun about a month ago, have been carrying it most of the time ever since, and I want to visit with you today about some issues and idiosyncrasies that I've come up with in the carrying of the gun. I'm not going to do a review on it. If you want to get a great review of this gun, just simply buzz on over to Gun Blast, and Jeff has a video as well as a very nice article that details this gun quite well. He also has his video on the Charter Arms website if you'd like to see it there. What we're going to talk about today is some of the carryability of this as far as issues, especially when it comes to the possibility of speed loading this gun. If you're not familiar with these little revolvers that chamber the pistol rounds, let me kind of compare that to the regular 38, which most of you are familiar with, and then we'll proceed on with our discussion about the reloading and speed loading of this little gun. First of all, let me kind of go over a little bit with you the 642. This is the familiar Smith 642. Most of you have probably shot this gun. This is a carry gun of mine. I've carried it for quite some time. So why would I want to carry this Pitbull if I like this one so well? Well, here's the reason. It's the 40 Smith & Wesson cartridge. There's just no cartridge, in my opinion, as nice as that little cartridge to carry or to shoot. And then there's some other possibilities that I'm going to show you in a little bit of what we can do by carrying two guns using the same cartridge. Now, the 38, when you're loading or speed loading, the cartridges literally just fall in. There is no obstruction at all to the chambers, so there's nothing obstructing you when you're loading, or when you use like this HKS loader, you just put it right in, you twist it, and they'll immediately fall in. Well, I'm not going to do that, so we can leave this thing unloaded here, but it's very easy, as most of you know, to speed load this gun. Now let's kind of get back over here to the Pitbull and some of the differences of this. Well, it's pretty obvious right away that there's something in the chamber that's creating a little obstruction, and that is the ejection pin. That little ejection pin is necessary because we're dealing with a rimless cartridge, and it's got to actually go in that little depression there on the rimless cartridge, the back of that case, and eject it out. You don't have to mess with that on a 38 because it's rimmed, and the little ejector will just catch the rim and push it right out. That's not really a problem, but it's different. And the differences are loading and reloading because of that little pin. Now, Charter Arms is not the only company that has revolvers that are chambered for pistol rounds. Smith has had them off and on, Ruger, Taurus. The difference is those guns don't use an ejection system like this, like the spring-loaded, just like the 38s do. They use moon clips. In moon clips, you load the little moon clip, as most of you know, and then you put in the moon clip, take it in and out, so we won't go through that, but the moon clip system has been around for a long time and works quite well for most people. So why switch? Well, this is just a neat little system. I like it. I like that it does the unloading similar to the other revolvers, but if you like the moon clips, then so be it. There's certainly guns out there that use moon clips. Charter Arms has developed this little system without them. If you want to see moon clips probably utilized to perfection, go to Julie Gollum's site and watch her shoot the National Pistol, the National Revolver contest this last year. She used a Smith revolver and won that contest using moon clips as her speed loaders. Very impressive if you want to go see that. So let's talk just a little bit now about some of the issues that you run into with this gun. First of all, you got to get a little bit used to loading them, because to get past that little ejection point there that you see, the rounds don't just slide in, you have to push them in. So when you're loading the gun, you have to push the rounds in. But as they get past that little pin, the little pin then catches and ejects them out. So it has to have that little pin on this system. This is a copyrighted system that Charter Arms has come up with. Works quite well. The issue comes in as far as reloading or speed loading. After you've used those five rounds, you got to figure out some way to get this thing speed loaded. I thought when I got the gun that there'd probably be speed loaders out there of some kind for it. Charter Arms does not have them. I call them. They have not developed that yet. They probably will, but I don't know that. And they certainly didn't share that they were coming out with it anytime soon. I thought maybe some of the aftermarket companies, as HKS, would have a speed loader of some kind for it. They don't either. So as of now, unless you know something I don't know, there's no speed loaders out there for this gun. What kind of issues does that create? Well, when you look at Jeff's review of this, he doesn't feel that's much issue, because the likelihood of getting in any defensive situation needing more than five rounds, probably pretty low. But I'm just like you out there. When I carry a pistol, I carry an extra magazine or two. When I carry the 642, I carry an HKS speed loader or two. So even though there's a low likelihood of it, it is nice in case you get into that rare situation that you do have the ability to carry more than five rounds for your gun. Now, yeah, you can carry more than five with this, no problem. But if you get into a situation after you fired these first five to reload, you got to kind of fumble around in your pocket or somewhere and reload these. You know, get them in there and push them in and reload. Well, in a gunfight situation, there's no timeout. So that could present a problem. And that's what we're talking about today. In one of the forums, one of the gentlemen had an interesting comment about reloading or speed loading this gun, and that's to use a regular magazine for a pistol and utilize that as a speed loader. It actually works pretty neat. It's not quite like the HKS where you drop it in and turn it and you're going. It may not even be called a speed loader, but it is a way to reload and have your cartridges in an efficient way to carry them and then reload. It's not real fast, but it can be done. And I think with a little practice, we'll all get faster with it. Let me show you how it's done. I may fumble around with this, but you'll see you've got to push the cartridge in. You get it there, and you push it in. The next one comes up ready, push it in. See, that works actually quite well. It's not bad. So you just push the cartridge in, we're loaded. So get all those back out again. So that's the system, that the only system I know that's available for quickly reloading this little gun. Let's don't call it a speed loader, we'll call it a reloader. Here's the other aspect of this that's kind of neat, and that is that if you carry this gun as a backup and you're carrying a Glock 23 as your primary, all you've got to do is have your Glock magazines loaded with 40 cals and you're ready to go. You can load your Glock 23 with them. You can load your Pitbull with them. So the neat thing with this is that you've got one set of magazines, one set of reloaders for both guns. If you just carry this gun, just utilize your Glock magazine or M&P magazine, whatever 40 caliber magazine you have, as your little speed loader. So that does work quite well. It's the only system I know out there for this, but it does give those of us that want to carry this little gun another method of keeping up with and loading it in case we need to do so in a defensive situation. It's a dandy little gun, as Jeff Quinn says. I enjoy it. It's a great little carry gun, comfortable to shoot, more accurate than I am. I hope you've enjoyed this and it's helped you some. If you have comments about other methods or better improvement on these methods, please let us know in the comments. Hope you have a great day, and hope to see you again at Real Guys Reviews. Thank you.